Hey guys, I am out going to do carpet stretching today here. I was called out to do about 5 rooms and it turned out only the hall. So we're going to take a look at the hall here, show you what I'm going to do. This room, it could almost use a little bit of a stretching, but it's just not that big of a deal, and I like to try to save the client money if I can. So we're going to stretch the hall. The hall is wrinkled here into the bedroom. I'm thinking maybe this is all just due to footwear. So I'm going to cut the hall in two. I'm going to stretch together and re-seam it. And that's all that's going to happen here. And mainly, most of it's going to be done right in this area here. So I'm going to go grab some tools and bring them up here and begin. I got to find where I'm going to set my... I've got the camera on the small tripod today here. So I think... Let's see what my field of vision is here. Something about like that will do, looks like. So I'll check back in a minute. All right, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cut the doorway here. We're gonna be pulling the carpet both directions here. So we're gonna cut, say about right here. Bad thing about the doorway is you're usually cutting through a previous seam or some tape or something. It's not a huge deal, I'd rather not, but I think we're gonna do it that way today. Then I generally finish it out with scissors. Then pull it up all along the walls, the directions that you're going to be pulling from here, and on the other side you pull it up so the tack strip doesn't hold it in place. And behind the door. Now I get my carpet stretcher over here. Seam stretcher, that is. A little different. Stretcher has a foot on both ends of it for pulling the carpet together. And I never pull the carpet just once, it's usually a few times. Aesthetically fixes it. It's not fixed. There's still wrinkle over here on the other side. Let that sit for a little while and I pull one side then the other, and sometimes I'll take a knee kicker and one of the other power stretchers and use that to stretch the other side at the same time. Probably on here today, probably going to use stay nails to hold it together, but I will check back in a few minutes. other side, this way. Now, the next step is to cut the overlap piece out. Turn the blade around. It's already made one trip through the carpet, so it's important that the blade stay clean, fresh, and new. So you turn it around almost every time you cut. You can adjust this with your knee kicker. I'm going to put the tape under it and then plug some irons in here. Thank you. camera off for a minute, and I'm going to plug in my irons and come back and seam this back together. This one's going to require some seam adjusting. Okay, I'm gonna let that cool for a minute. Now I'm gonna pull some nails out on the outside of each one and push the carpet in a little more, re-nail it, and then do the outsides. Okay, what I did was I took the nails out, I kicked both sides forward and put stay nails to hold them together. Side, I'll melt that together. Okay.
have to go get the cash. Hey, Corey?
Uh-huh. Okay, we're pretty much all done here. I'm going to tuck the carpet in, and I'm going to put the camera down. You can see me tucking the carpet in, and then we will take a look at it when I'm completely done here. So let's see what your range of view is here. It's pretty good. Also, I was asked to fix the squeaky floor here, which was right over in this area here. I'm not going to be able to fix it today because it's not squeaking today. I've done this a handful of times in the past. It's not something people know that you as a carpet guy can fix. Basically, what it amounts to is you roll the carpet back. In this case, you would cut the carpet and then cut some of the padding out, basically. And then you find where the two boards are rubbing, you put a bead of glue inside it, and then you shoot screws down into it carefully, not too long of screws, and not, the main thing, you don't want to pierce anything plumbing or electrical. So you verify that you're screwing into a stud several times. You screw it down, and the screws will hold it, and if there's any play left in it, the glue will pick it up after that. So it's not something you're asked for maybe once or twice a year, because people don't know you can do that. I've done that before, and I've also done some stuff where people want cables ran under the carpet. Another service that I can do, but I don't advertise that because I have trouble getting home as is. Alright. Now, finish with this. Back together the carpet. This is this much shorter now, and I was thinking you were going to be able to see the seam in the middle because of the wear, but it looks like it turned out really well. So yeah, looks like we're good here. God bless seaming from the topper. Okay guys, I am going to put my tools away, and I'm going to fit an extra job in today. Somebody asked if there was any extra time today, and I finished this job early, so I'm going to go fit another client in that I had for later in the week. I'll see you guys at this job. Thanks for watching.